Hi guys, when we take a look at this planet right here, we see that this is a planet that has around 7.8 billion people in population. And most importantly, 71%, according to a source from Wikipedia, 71% of this planet is covered by water and only 29% is covered by land. So 7.8 billion people are fighting for that remaining 29% of land that is accessible to human beings. Now here's where the Bhagavad Gita asks an interesting question. For what? When we are going in search of finding something where we can stay for this body that is beyond our need and trying to satisfy a want that is never going to be satisfied in the first place, the question is, for what? We really do not know for what, because the main reason the Bhagavad Gita brings this particular topic up is because many people in the world, back then, now, and this is not going to end as long as human life is going to go, that is, people believing that they are really powerful. People believing that they can make a significant change at the snap of their finger. But the question here is, can they really? Can someone really be powerful enough to make a change? Yes, we can make a change as long as the change is natural. An unnatural change cannot be made possible just because a person is at par. Now you take a look at many great leaders, or you take a look at many great, you know, fighters or warriors or any sort of corporate CEOs, all these people who think that they are powerful and the changes that they have made go in line with nature and not against nature. If anyone is wanting to go against nature, their empire or their findings are no longer relevant. Now I'll give you a very small example for that. Take someone like Alexander the Great. Ever since we were little, when we were learning history, we have always been taught that how much he conquered the world, how close he came in conquering the entire ancient world. The question is, where is his empire today? His empire does not last. Same thing for Hitler. Same thing for many people who built only until their life was present. However, on the other hand, if we take a look at someone like Plato, Socrates, Aristotle, or even the Bhagavad Gita for that matter, all these things, though it was written 5,000 years ago, or in Greek something around 2,500 years ago, they are still relevant in modern times. From this, what are we able to understand? It is not that the person that is making a mark in the history, but their works that is making a mark in history and standing the test of time. So the works of the Bhagavad Gita, the works of the great Greek philosophers, all these things went with nature, along with nature, and not against nature. This is why the Bhagavad Gita says a very famous verse, which says that a human being cannot have the power in order to change nature, but can only adjust with nature. The reason this is being said is because to enable every human being to think that they are really not powerful, they are powerless, and making one understand and realize that they are powerless is a rather a long-term process than that of a short-term one. Now I'll give you one small example for that. When we take a look at nature, we would be able to feel that sometimes nature does not want us to do this, and on the other side, nature itself will push us. Now this is why the saying that a human being is powerless, it can be an overwhelming feeling that how powerless a human being can really be. But at the same time, being powerless doesn't mean that we human beings are worthless. There is always a catch to every statement that is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. For example, a human body, if we take a look at the entire structure of the human body, it is designed in a way where we can attain anything and everything that we want in this world. But at the same time, there is something placed before us that does not allow us to travel that path known as our ego. Now, if we take that ego out, then we would be as capable as any other divine being in this world. Now, a person who has an ego, passion or desire, and that of a person who does not, is verily the distinction between human and divine as per the Bhagavad Gita. And that is the theme of these verses in this book. And the first step that we have to follow in order to follow these verses is just to free our mind, and it will always lead the way. Now that's a wrap for this particular episode. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, do give it a thumbs up, and also do hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. And as always, thank you for watching.